Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 24 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed up to question number 51. Today we are going to look into question number 52. So let's go. You have an Azure subscription named subscription 1 that contains a virtual network named VNet 1. VNet 1 is in resource group named resource group 1. Subscription 1 has a user named user 1. User 1 has the following roles. It has reader role, it has security admin role, it has security reader role. You need to ensure that user 1 can assign the reader role for VNet 1 to other users. What should you do? So before we jump to our answers here, we'll first understand what the reader role is, what is the security admin role is, and what is the security reader role, which is already assigned to user 1. So let's jump to the definitions. Also keep in mind that these roles are Azure built-in roles, which is we can call it Azure role-based access control, and in short we call it RBAC. RBAC. So the first role is reader role. Reader actually can read a resource detail of any type of resource. So that what a reader has. So the reader cannot change anything on the resource, but can read all the properties of resource. Next one is security reader. Security reader role is having permission for Microsoft Defender for cloud, and can view recommendations, alerts, and security policy and security state of any resource, and cannot make any change. So no change, it's like reader but having additional capability on security aspect. Next one is security admin. Have all these readers capabilities, means all these capabilities security admin is having, means can view, but furthermore the security admin role can update also the permission for Microsoft Defender for cloud, and the same permission as security reader role. So all these permissions we have already noted, and can also update the security policy and dismiss alerts and recommendations. So security admin is having more security related permissions, where mainly security admin can update the security policy and update the permission for Microsoft Defender for cloud. Two more roles we are going to discuss is user access administrator role and network contributor role, because these are mentioned in answers or option we have given. So user access administrator can, you know, have this role, can assign the role to others, and other one is the owner also can assign. So these two roles are have, you know, permissions to assign roles to other users. So this is what user access administrator does. And network contributor can manage the network. So this role can configure and manage the network related resource. So this role is applicable on only and only network related resource, and do not have any access to other Azure resources. So other resources which are not having any network configuration have no access to this role. So I think this is very clear from this definition. Let's move to question. Now we'll go through the options available. So option D, assign user 1 the network contributor role. And as we know from the definition, network contributor role can configure and manage network related resource. But our objective here is to provide the access or reader role to other users. So for that, this will not work. Option C is assign user 1 the network contributor role on VNet 1. So either we are providing a network contributor role on resource group, or on the resource itself, it is not going to help to give the permission to other users. So that will help only to manage or configure the network resource. So this is also wrong answer. Option B is assign user 1 the user access administrator. And as we know from the definition that this user access administrator role is specifically designed to assign the role to other users or other members. So this is the correct answer here. And option A is remove user 1 from security reader and reader role for subscription. Definitely it's not going to help in assigning other users any role. So option A is also wrong. So option B is the correct answer. Let's move to next question. Question number 53. You have an Azure Active Directory tenant named Contoso Cloud on Microsoft.com. Your company has a public DNS zone for Contoso.com. You add Contoso.com as custom domain name to Azure Active Directory. You need to ensure that Azure can verify the domain name. Which type of DNS record should you create? So as we know that the reason for domain verification is primarily to prevent misuse or fraudulent use of domains, but Azure supports MX record for verification and TXT record for verification, domain verification. So probably in exam we may have one option available with the MX record, but maybe we may have another question which is having TXT record in place. So keep in mind that we may have this question and we may have two answers, means maybe MX is available, then we'll select MS, otherwise we'll select the TXT record. Same time also we are going to check this on Azure portal as well. So we are in our Azure portal now and we'll go to Active Directory, we'll go to custom domain names, and we'll add custom domain. And I will quickly add one. And I'll hit add. And as you see, we do have two options available for any domain to add. One is TXT record. So only two record type are supported on Azure. And another one is MX. So these entries we can put and we can verify this. I hope I was able to explain these questions properly. I hope this video was informative for you. And if you like the video, please press the like button, subscribe, and press bell notification icon to receive the notification. Share with your friends. Thank you for watching and see you in next video.